Once upon a time, there was a farmer who had a parrot at home. The parrot spoke well, and everyone liked it. A bat lived in the same house. He too liked the parrot. One night, when everyone was asleep, the bat heard someone singing sweetly.
"What a beautiful voice!"
It went outside to see.
"Where is this voice coming from?"
He finally saw the parrot singing. He was very happy to see the parrot.
"Hey, you sing very sweetly."
"Thank you."
"Your voice is very sweet."
"It is I."
"I will get a fruit as a present for you for your sweet song."
"Thank you, my friend."
The bat left the place. The next morning, the bat came with a fruit to the parrot.
"Thank you, my friend."
The next night, again, the parrot started to sing.
"Again, here comes a sweet melody from my sweet friend."
The bat went and met the parrot.
"Hey, you have started to sing again."
"I love singing."
"Sweetie, but why don't you sing in the morning?"
"I don't like to sing in the morning."
"But why?"
"There is a big story behind that."
"What is it?"
"One day, I was in the field and I was singing happily. Attracted by my voice, a hunter came and caught me. I had forgotten my surroundings while singing and had not seen the hunter. Now look at my fate. That hunter sold me to this farmer." "Why do you laugh?"
"Don't mistake me. Already you are in a cage. Even if you sing in the morning, who's going to catch you?"
"You are right. But if someone else takes me away from here..."
"No one will take you from here."
"Yes, I should have thought about it long back. I will start singing in the morning too, from tomorrow."
"You are right."
The bat gave another fruit to the parrot for its sweet voice. Moral: precautions are useless after the crisis. No use bolting the stables after the horses have left.
"You keep quiet. Look at these cranes. They happily gorge themselves and then flying off to another pond in minutes. Look at us."
The fish scarcely gave ear to all his grumbling. It dived into the water and started enjoying itself.